Richard Hakluyt, 1551 to 1616. One of the great names that comes into the story of exploration in Elizabethan times is that of the younger Richard Hakluyt, an English clergyman who himself traveled no farther afield than Paris. The men who did the actual exploring in those days were often fine sailors, yet few of them knew how to write down accounts of their voyages. So it was fortunate that a scholarly man like Hakluyt was interested enough to collect news of all these voyages and to encourage and help these who were anxious to find new lands. He had been enthusiastic about geography from his school days, and after leaving Oxford University, he became the friend of Francis Drake and Humphrey Gilbert. Whereas they are chiefly remembered for their voyages of discovery, Hakluyt won his reputation as their first and perhaps greatest English chronicler. Hakluyt's first book about the discoveries being made in America was written in 1582. 2 years later, he wrote another book on the same subject, hoping this time to persuade the Queen to support Walter Raleigh's scheme for an English colony in Virginia, on the east coast of what is now the United States. He learned four languages so that he could read accounts of explorations by foreigners, and when he was in Bristol, London, and Paris, he talked with all who could give him information about other lands, and particularly about those that had just been discovered. In 1589, the year after the defeat of Spanish Armada, he published his greatest book, The Principal Navigations, Voyages and Discoveries of the English Nation. By 1600, he had enlarged this book until it filled three big volumes. Still, he went on collecting stories, and after his death, there were found to be enough for another great volume. Hakluyt was buried in Westminster Abbey. An edition of Hakluyt's writing has been specially prepared for children by Ronald Syme. It's called Hakluyt's Sea Stories.